Welcome to Fix It Home Improvement, covering projects that every homeowner should know and great products for home and garden.
Hi, I'm JC, and this is where we share weekly home improvement tips. I'm here with my co-host, Cindy.
Hello, JC.
Hi, Cindy. This week, we're going to be talking about Radon Action Month, and we'd like to thank Mike Anderson for liking and sharing the podcast. This week, we spoke to Erica from Easy Breathe about adding a ventilation system to reduce radon levels in your home. And next week, we'll let you know when we're going to be publishing our 13th ebook, and we're going to have a 5-day promotion. You'll be able to get it free on Amazon. In the 1500s, a Swiss physician described a disease in miners, but it wasn't until the late 1800s it was recognized as lung cancer caused by radioactive substances. In the 1950s, radon was recognized as an indoor air pollutant. The International Agency for Research on Cancer classified radon as a human carcinogen in 1988, and it wasn't until 2005 the U.S. Surgeon General released a health advisory about the dangers of radon in homes. The Environmental Protection Agency has designated January as National Radon Action Month. They're encouraging organizations to spread the word about the dangers of radon and encouraging people to tell family and friends about testing their homes for radon. Mm-hmm. Radon is a radioactive gas that comes from the natural decay of uranium found in soil and rock, and it works its way into your home from cracks and gaps in your home's foundation, and it can build up to dangerous levels. Testing is the only way to know the radon level in your home. There's no smell or taste, and it's the leading cause of lung cancer in non-smokers.
Scary.
The EPA says over 20,000 people die of radon-induced cancer every year. The American Cancer Society says some studies suggest radon exposure may be linked to other types of cancer like childhood leukemia.
Really?
And for most people, the largest potential source of radon exposure is their home. The EPA is estimating 1 in 15 homes in the U.S. has elevated levels of radon, and action should be taken to reduce the levels. Radon can be found all over the U.S., and any type of home can have high levels, whether it's new, old, big, or small. It's all about the soil and the rock that's under and around your home's foundation. Radon is measured in picocuries per liter of air, and you'll see the abbreviation small case P, capital C, small case I, / capital L. The EPA says the average outdoor level of radon is 0.4 picocuries per liter of air, and the average indoor level is 1.3 picocuries.
Right.
The EPA recommends taking action to reduce the level of radon in your home if you test and it's at 4 picocuries or higher. The World Health Organization recommends lowering the radon level when it reaches 3 picocuries. The National Cancer Institute says there is no safe level of radon gas and you should try to reduce levels to as low as you can get them. And radon levels can vary between homes in a neighborhood. It's all about the soil and the rock under your home.
Right.
And just because your neighbor said they tested their home and they have low levels, that doesn't mean that you'll necessarily have low levels in your home.
Right.
Radon levels vary between states. One study done in Iowa found 70% of the homes tested exceeded the action level. The Pennsylvania Department of Environmental Protection urges all homeowners in Pennsylvania to test their homes for radon due to the geology in the state. And they say winter is the best time to test because doors and windows are closed and sealed,
right,
and that's going to give you the most accurate results. In 2014, the highest level of radon ever recorded in a U.S. home was in Pennsylvania. The concentration was 3,700 picocuries.
Wow.
900 times the EPA's action level.
Yikes.
Yeah, scary. If the radon level in your home is at 2 picocuries, about 4 people in 1,000 could get lung cancer. If you're a smoker, the risk jumps to about 32 out of 1,000. At 4 picocuries, your risk of lung cancer is 7 out of 1,000. If you're a smoker, 62 out of 1,000. The American Association of Radon Scientists and Technologists says that a radon level of 4 picocuries is like smoking 8 cigarettes a day or getting 200 chest x-rays a year. A radon level of 20 picocuries is like smoking 40 cigarettes a day or having 1,000 chest x-rays a year.
How many chest x-rays should you have in a year?
Not 1,000. Curie, C-U-R-I-E, is a measurement of the intensity of radioactivity of a radioactive material, and it was named after Marie and Pierre Curie. The highest levels of radon are usually found in the lowest level of your home, your basement, or a crawl space. The EPA and the Surgeon General recommend testing in all homes below the third level. Mm-hmm. There's two types of radon detection devices, passive and active. Passive radon detectors are opened in the area that you're testing, and radon gas is trapped in charcoal, or radon is leaving tracks in a special plastic. And these are the most common devices. Then you have to mail in this test to the lab to be analyzed after a specific time. Mm-hmm. But you need to read the instructions thoroughly with these passive tests because each test is a little different.
Because some you leave out for 7 days or 10 days.
Right. Yeah. Some are 2 days. Hmm. So you really need to read. One of the kits I looked at said the following condition should exist 12 hours before and during the test period. It said keep all windows closed, keep all exterior doors closed except for normal entering and exiting. Fans and ventilation that use outside air like attic fans, kitchen and bath exhaust fans shouldn't be used. Maintain your normal living temperature. And do not test if storms or high winds are predicted during the test period. Measure in the lowest lived-in area of your home. Do not use the test kit in a bathroom, a kitchen, or a laundry room. The monitor should be placed 20 inches above the floor, 3 feet from an outside wall, windows, and doors, and keep the test kit out of an area with drafts or excess heat. And don't place on granite surfaces, because granite gives off radon.
Oh, no.
And this was for a 2-day test kit. You're going to open the detector, you're going to mark the date on it, then after 2 days you seal it up and you mail it to the lab for your results.
Okay.
Active radon detectors use electric, and the most common devices have a digital display, or it works with an app on your phone. Mm-hmm. And this is going to give you continuous measurements of the radon level in your home. There are two types of tests. There are short-term, which are usually 2 to 90 days, and long-term, which are 90 days to a year. With the passive detectors, they're very low cost. I saw test kits from $10 to $25, but read the label. Some of these kits have an additional fee for the lab, but some are included in the price.
Right.
So they're very low cost. They're easy to use. The electronic continuous radon detectors are more expensive, but you can see the short-term and the long-term radon in your home. Plus, you can share this with family and friends. I spoke to Sylvain. It's S-Y-L-V-A-N-E. They sell indoor air quality products. They said their top-rated active radon detectors are the Safety Siren Pro 4 and the AirThings Radon Gas Monitor. The Safety Siren Pro 4 samples the air continuously and updates the LCD display every hour, and you would plug this into an outlet. It shows the short-term radon levels over the last 48 to 168 hours, and it shows the long-term radon levels for the length of time the detector's been turned on or reset, up to 365 days.
Hmm.
And this has audible alarms and a visual alarm for high radon levels. The AirThings radon gas monitor uses 3 AAA batteries. It has a digital display that shows the long-term radon average over the last year and the short-term radon average over the last 24 hours and the last 7 days.
Right.
Out of the active radon detectors I've seen, they range from around $140 to $200.
Mm-hmm.
You can check out Sylvain at sylvane.com. And if you click on their Knowledge Center tab, they have some good blog articles.
Cool.
Some top-rated passive radon test kits come from ProLab. It's ProLab, RSSI Alpha Track, and it's just the letters RSSI, KIDDE, K-I-D-D-E, First Alert, and AccuStar, A-C-C-U, capital S-T-A-R. And you can get these at your local hardware store, a home center, or online.
Right.
If you plan on using a passive radon test, the EPA recommends doing a short-term test first. If you have a radon level of 4 picocuries or higher, follow up with a second short-term test to confirm it, or do a long-term test. If your test comes back below 4 picocuries, you should retest again in the future, and you should test at any time during the year. But if you test during the summer, I would retest again in winter if you have something below 4 picocuries, because you're going to get the best results during winter.
Okay.
I spoke to AirThings. It's AirThings. They have different radon detectors and air quality monitors. They suggest if you have radon levels between 1.4 and 2.6 picocuries, check your basement, crawl space, and foundation for cracks and gaps. Seal them with caulk and then add ventilation.
Mm-hmm.
If you have levels between 2.7 and 4, and it stays at that range for more than 3 months, you should install a radon mitigation system. The EPA recommends adding ventilation to improve indoor air quality. For some homes, just adding a basement or crawl space ventilation system will reduce the radon levels to a safer level. Plus, it's going to help reduce humidity, VOCs, and other air pollutants.
Mm-hmm.
Some top-rated companies with crawl space and basement ventilation systems: Easy Breathe, it's capital E, capital Z, capital B-R-E-A-T-H-E, Chernlund, T-J-E-R-N-L-U-N-D, and AC Infinity, it's capital A, capital C, capital I-N-F-I-N-I-T-Y. If you have high radon levels, there are three main radon mitigation systems. Subslab is the most common. A hole is made through the concrete floor slab, and a 3 or 4 inch PVC pipe is put down through that hole into the crushed rock or the soil under your slab.
Right.
The pipe is then vented out the side of your house, and it goes above the roof line, or the pipe will go through your house, up through the attic, and out the roof.
Mm-hmm.
If you have a sump pit, you can get a sealed radon cover, and then you would run a 3 or 4 inch PVC pipe from your sump pit, and that would exhaust the same way.
Right.
If you have a crawl space with a soil or rock floor, the crawl space floor would be covered with plastic and sealed. Then PVC pipe would be put under the plastic to vent radon out of the house.
Hmm.
The radon mitigation systems can be passive with no fan, or it can be active, which has a radon fan that's going to be running continuously to draw radon out of the house. The fan will usually be mounted outside or in the attic, depending on how the PVC pipe is run.
Okay. So we have a radon detector.
Yep.
One of the AirThings. I've passed it out to all my cousins.
Yeah, which is great.
A couple of my cousins have brand new houses, and their radon was so high we had to put in one of the radon mitigation systems.
Well, your one cousin has a passive, or he had a passive radon system that was built into his new home, but we tested the levels in his basement, and it was 3.9 picocuries. So we cut into the PVC pipe, and we put in one of these Chernlund booster fans, and the level has stayed right around 1.7.
Right, because he has young kids, and it's an unfinished basement, and they play down there all the time with their bikes and stuff, so...
Yeah, amazing.
Yeah, I mean, terrifying.
Well, how you can take something, just by putting in a fan, how you can take something that's potentially dangerous and make it better.
I gave it to my uncle, and his basement was fine, and I mean, his house is 40 years old, so... And that's just down the street from my cousin with the brand new house.
And then your other cousin had a very high level, and I was trying to find my notes, I couldn't find them, but they had a very high level in their basement, and they have kids also. We put in a radon mitigation system that went through the sidewall of the basement And it brought it down to a very low level.
We had to cut a 6-inch hole in their siding in a brand new house, buddy.
Yeah, I was a little nervous going through their siding. Hey, I'm going to put a 6-inch hole in your new siding.
So, yeah.
If you plan on having a professional install a radon mitigation system, Kansas State University recommends looking up the National Radon Safety Board or the National Radon Proficiency Program online, and you can find a nationally certified professional in your area. Many states certify or license radon contractors. They suggest looking up your state radon office, and they'll help you find a professional in your area.
Cool.
The American Association of Radon Scientists and Technologists, they're a nonprofit trade organization, they recommend finding a professional that's certified by the NRPP.
What is that?
That's the National Radon Proficiency Program. And this is a certification program for radon professionals. And they have to update their qualifications once every 2 years.
Hmm.
And you can check out NRPP for local contractors at nrpp.info, I-N-F-O. Over 30 states have statutes about radon. In some states, you have to disclose all radon results if your home has high levels of radon. The EPA recommends testing your home for radon before you sell, and if necessary, lower the radon level. Save all your test results and any steps you took to reduce the levels. It can be a positive selling point. If you're buying a home, ask the seller for radon levels and any test results. If they haven't done any radon testing, ask them to do a test before you purchase the home. And if they did mitigation, get all the information on the system and all the test results. We spoke to Easy Breathe about radon and their ventilation system. Erica, how you doing?
I'm doing well, JC. How are you today?
Real good. Cindy and I are talking about Radon Action Month, and I was hoping that you could share some tips for homeowners with your Easy Breathe ventilation system.
I'd love to. Well, radon is a very serious thing. Most people don't really think about radon much until they're trying to sell their home, and that's part of the selling process is to get a radon test. And then it becomes sometimes a giant obstacle for people looking to sell their homes. But it's also, you know, it increases the risk of lung cancer, and it oftentimes gets trapped in our homes, giving us another contaminant that we need to be worried about, rightfully so. It's very, very detrimental. It's a radioactive gas. So that is something we all should be more aware of. Some of the tips, obviously, is test your home. There's radon tests that I think you can get over the counter that will give you at least some sort of indication of where your radon level is. All radon is bad. I know that the EPA recommends certain action levels and certain things, but the bottom line is radon is a bad thing to breathe at any level. So our goal is to prevent radon levels from building up to any sort of concentration. So through the ventilation process, we're able to assist homeowners in reducing the radon levels that actually start acquiring and concentrating within the basement or the crawl space or the slab itself.
Even if you have a radon mitigation system, a whole house ventilation system will still be beneficial?
Yes, yes. Most radon mitigation systems deal with sub-slab collection. So that means they put a hole in the basement floor, they put in some venting and some pipes that draw that gas that collects underneath the slab, and they evacuate it. I believe it's got to be like 20 feet above the ground level. So oftentimes this pipe runs up through the center of the house and gets evacuated somewhere up on the second floor. Where indoor ventilation comes into play inside the basement itself, the Easy Breathe draws that air and the radon that makes its way in through the walls, because collecting it sub-slab is really collecting the radon before it enters the home. But even with those systems, many radon mitigation contractors supplement their system with an Easy Breathe, because even with those sub-slab radon mitigation systems, radon still creeps in through the walls of the basement or crawl space, because it's a naturally occurring gas in the soil. So wherever there's soil surrounding the home, there's the potential for radon. And it varies wherever you are in the country. Some areas have higher radon instances than others. It's existing naturally in the soil, and then it gets absorbed into the home. So we actually address any radon that's actually in the home itself or in the basement. So through our ventilation process, we're able to capture all sorts of contaminants that you and I have discussed, you know, many, many times. Radon is simply one of the contaminants that Easy Breathe has a positive effect on, meaning that the radon level inside, when it's measured before an Easy Breathe is installed, and then you install the Easy Breathe and we measure that with that same instrument, the radon significantly decreases with a Easy Breathe ventilation system running.
Yeah, I read an article by the EPA, and they said in some cases, radon levels can be lowered just by ventilation.
Correct. And we have many, many, many homeowners that call us. This is a first step before all of the expense and energy that's put into a radon mitigation system that's oftentimes unsightly, and it isn't necessarily something homeowners want to deal with. They'll try to tackle it with an Easy Breathe system. And sometimes that's enough. We're able to get it below that action level. And sometimes, depending on what the level is, there needs to be a second step. A radon mitigator once explained to me why ventilation works with reducing radon levels, because I guess the raw gas that gets entered into the building itself is not necessarily as detrimental as the radon itself. So radon is born from what they call daughter elements that are produced when the raw gas is broken down. So as soon as that raw gas attaches to any sort of organic material, cardboard boxes, couches, furnishings, anything that may be stored in that lower level, this off-gassing or this daughter element production of the radon gas starts happening. So he explained to me that when you're ventilating the space, it doesn't allow that raw gas to start populating and landing on things, which starts that byproduct of the daughter elements of the real dangerous, the radon radioactive byproduct. So if you can keep the air moving, it doesn't allow for that process to even start. So I thought that was very interesting, because when I first started in this industry, you know, I didn't understand how any of this happened. So when he explained it in a really layman's terms like that, I thought, well, yeah, by moving the air, we don't allow that process to even take place.
And with ventilation, it's got to be a great selling point if you're thinking about selling your home.
Oh, absolutely. We have a lot of different real estate agents that utilize our product and recommend it to homeowners for lots of different reasons, not, you know, specifically radon like we talked about, but also, you know, depending on how long the house sits on the market or how long the house sits empty or whatever sort of, you know, specific scent, let's say, that the home has. All homes have odors, right? We get used to them. But when a new person walks in or a potential buyer walks into the home, right, that oftentimes is the first thing that they sense. We've had in our own personal experience looking at properties, you know, real estate agents that run in and they turn on all the lights and they turn on all the vent fans and they even maybe open some windows to try to get air moving. So when we walk in, we're not hit with that wall of whatever that, you know, signature scent of that home is. You know, we have a great testimonial. A home was on the market 80 plus days. And within 3 weeks of putting the Easy Breathe in, the home sold. And that's all that it needed was just a fresher, cleaner, healthier indoor air quality. And by keeping the air moving and evacuating the dirtiest, dampest, most polluted air where radon lives, right, in the lowest level, sure, by getting all of that air out of the house and creating air exchanges through foundation ventilation, that sometimes is all it needs to get buyers to say, yeah, this is the one.
And if you have tests that show the indoor air quality, that's got to be helpful selling a home.
Yeah, that's becoming more and more popular, and potential buyers are becoming more and more in tune with that, given everything that we've gone through in the last year with air quality and contaminants and what we're breathing and how it affects our home, our health. So yeah, we're doing a lot of that as well. Homeowners getting the air quality tested, and they call on us and we'll do a test. And inevitably, as you've known yourself, you put an Easy Breathe in and you test it again and everything, all the levels improve, meaning they decrease. So the home becomes healthier once you start actively ventilating, you know, the foundation. It has a whole home effect of improving the indoor air quality throughout the whole structure. Potential buyers are looking at that now as a real asset and a reason to buy a home. homes that have ventilation systems. They're much more desirable.
And with your ventilation systems, this is something a homeowner could put in themselves or have a professional install?
Yes, yes. We have various models for different size structures and different foundation types, all of which are available with a professional installation that we can help arrange with a local installer that's near you, or also as a self-installation kit, which has been very, very popular this past year. So yeah, we make it very easy to get this product and start improving air quality.
And if I wanted to learn more about your ventilation systems, where would I go?
Our website is a great resource. That's the letter E, the letter Z, and then the word breathe, BREATHE.com. So easybreathe.com. Great resource to learn more about it.
Well, I appreciate your time, Erica. Thank you.
You're welcome. Have a great day, JC.
You too.
That was a great interview.
Yeah, I like systems like this. They improve the overall air quality in your home and could potentially make your home much healthier by reducing radon.
Mm-hmm. Do you have anything else to add?
Test your home for radon. You have no idea how high your radon levels are until you test. Encourage your family and friends to do radon tests. And if you have the budget for it, a digital radon detector is a great monitor to have along with your smoke detector and your CO detector. Mm-hmm. And you can share this with family and friends.
Right. Let's wrap this up.
You can subscribe to our podcast on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, CastBox, or your favorite podcast app.
If you enjoyed it, please leave us a review.
You can check out our home improvement videos on our YouTube channel, Fix It Home Improvement.
And you can subscribe to that as well.
You can download our ebooks, Home Improvement Solutions, What Every Homeowner Should Know, books 1 through 12, soon book 13 on Amazon.
If you enjoyed it, please leave us a 5-star rating and review.
You can email us at fixitpodcast@gmail.com. You can follow Cindy on Twitter @fixitcohost. And you can follow us on Instagram, Fix It Home Improvement.
Thank you for listening.
Talk to you next week. Deep.